Okay, so shall we do Merchants of Doubt?
No. Yes, okay.
Okay, fine. All right, we're not going to do Merchants of Doubt.
Well, you asked me the question. I suspected it might have been rhetorical.
Okay, so basically Merchants of Doubt is a documentary about the way in which scientific consensus can be made to disappear by conjuring up out of thin air the appearance of doubt. So it's directed by Robert Kennan. So we open in the magic cast. What?
No, I was pointing at Rory Ketherton-Jones, not you. He was taking photographs of us.
Oh, again. Okay. Shall I just carry on reviewing the films then?
I'm just doing something silently.
Okay, fine. So it's directed by Robert Kennan. So it opens in the magic castle in which we have a magician, a close magician, doing sort of sleight of hand tricks with a pack of cards. And one of the weird things was one of the people in the audience of this particular session is, oddly enough, somebody I know, which was kind of strange.
What, the movie?
In the movie, yes. I was watching the movie. I was watching a magician performing a card trick in a very small environment in the magic castle. No, it's not. It's the mother of a very good friend. Well, it's a very good friend of mine. Anyway, that doesn't. But that's just
a friend's
by the
mother or a friend.
Well, she's now a friend.
Oh right, is she an actress?
No.
Well, what's she doing in
the
movie?
She's a professor. She's in the audience watching somebody.
Well, just
do a...
coincidentally.
Yes.
Okay.
Right. So anyway, so we're in the magic castle, somebody doing a card trick, and the magician says, "Look, the thing about doing magic tricks is that people know that they're watching a magic trick, and that's fine. But then this is then used as a setup for actually what the film is discussing, which is the way in which media snake oil salesmen perform sleight of hand in the media to distract your attention from a sleight of hand card trick being done." So it starts off with saying, when the tobacco industry was faced with terrible proof that, cigarettes are bad for you, who knew? Well, apparently everyone knew for a very, very long time. All they needed to do in the paper was, rather than going out and fighting and saying, no, they're not bad for you, all they needed to do is to produce people who said, well, they might not be bad for you. There may be some doubt. There may be lack of consensus. This then jumps forward to climate change and says, you know all that stuff about whenever you have anybody on the television who says climate change is man-made and it's changing the planet, they automatically cut to another scientist who says, ah, well, there's no consensus, and in fact, there's a huge body of opinion. What this documentary argues is there is consensus. Believe me, there is consensus, but all this stuff that's happening over here is sleight of hand media magic. Here's a clip.
There's a bit of a mystery. What do these things all have in common? All of these issues are issues that involve the need for government action. That's when a penny dropped, because then I began to realize none of this is about the science. All of this is a political debate about the role of government. So in a number of places, we actually found these people saying they see environmentalists as creeping communists. They see them as reds under the bed. They call them watermelons, green on the outside, red on the inside. And they worry that environmental regulation will be a slippery slope to socialism.
So the film works its magic by slipping backwards and forwards between watching a magician performing a magic trick and then watching people on the media who appear to have scientific credibility.
Is it just American media or media more broadly than that?
It's American media primarily. Mm. And although actually it has a global aspect to it. And what it's about is the creation of the appearance of doubt. What it's about is conjuring doubt where there is none. What it's about is science being undermined by people saying, well, there is no consensus. I mean, one thing they do at one point, they go through all the scientific consensus on climate change, which is the climate changing, and we generally think that it is actually something that man is contributing to. And then suddenly people are produced saying, oh, well, that's absolutely not the case. And then it's investigating the science. And what you discover is, as you go back, looking back to what happened with the tobacco industry, that in fact, the principal and often the principal players are the same. People whose professional occupation is to create the appearance of doubt in order to prevent any form of change happening. It's a fascinating documentary. It's also quite an enraging documentary. I mean, I sat in a room of film critics watching it, and we came out and everybody felt the same thing, not enraged at the documentary, but enraged about the subject, enraged about just the level of filibustering that is going on.
Merchant of Doubt, which is what you were talking about.
Merchants.
Merchants of Doubt.
Yes.
That's the follow-on from Merchant of Doubt. It's very similar to what happened with the MMR discussion, which was often presented again as on the one hand this and on the other hand
this,
that.
Yeah.
Whereas actually, the consensus was no.
Yes.
It's perfectly safe to have the MMR vaccine, and on the other hand, it was just one guy and his mate. So often when those debates happen, it's an imbalanced one.
Yes, no,
but is this specifically a climate change move?
Well, it actually talks about it in a number of different areas. I said going back to smoking, but what it does is it exactly that idea that somehow you have to have balance. But if there is consensus, then maybe there's no balance because there is no need for balance. And what it's saying is, on the one hand, some people think this; on the other hand, some. So it's like flat earthing. It's like the Earth is round, but some people don't think it is. And here we have somebody.
And is the suggestion that the people are saying that there is some element of doubt? Is there some ulterior motive?
Yes, the suggestion is absolutely that they are paid large amounts of money in order to do that by the companies who have got an active interest. And of course, what it starts doing is tracking back as to who these companies are, and it becomes, you know, a great big conspiracy thing. And incidentally, in terms of that, who is the member of the audience? I don't know why I didn't say it's Carol Tavris, a woman called Carol Tavris, who is a brilliant academic and a close personal friend, and
the mother of just a friend.
Yes, it was just
there.
Yes.
That's very good. Thank you for the clarification.